How's it work? That's exactly right. You come in, you sit down, we spread out. So everybody's going to be like, you know, empty space between everybody, right? And you do your quiz, and when you're done with your quiz, you can go home. Quick and easy. You know what's going to be on the quiz?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. You do. Good. It's going to be a little easier than a lot of that. Yeah. Because on a lot of that, we had like you had things like the square root of x cubed and stuff, right? Was that confusing?
Yes.
Yeah? Yeah. Yeah. Ernesto, is that confusing to you too? Yeah. Well, let's talk about it. Let's, are you ready? Check this out. You're going to groan. You ready, Ernesto? Let's talk about it. Uh-huh. Yeah, I know. Sorry, Evelyn. For now?
Yeah.
Evelyn, what are your favorite kind of tacos? You're making me sad, though. You don't have your notes, Evelyn.
Oh, shit.
Oh, where? Check your shoe. Mine are good.
Meat ones?
Meat ones?
Yeah.
Meat ones. I've only ever had meat tacos. Yeah, I've only ever had meat. What about you, Jackie?
This guy.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Hmm. Okay. Interesting. Marlene, what's your favorite kind of taco?
Every taco's
a good taco. All right, I feel you. What about you, Yolanda? What's your favorite kind of taco?
I guess the ones I just had last night, ground beef. I mean, ground turkey.
Really?
Ground turkey, yep.
What'd you have on it?
Cheese.
Cheese?
That was it.
Really? No salsa? Oh, no onion?
I had no time for none of that.
Really?
I just had to get it down.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do you ever think your life is going to be this crazy?
No, I did not. But I did it to myself, I gotta say. At this point, anyway.
We always do.
Yeah.
Everybody always does.
Right?
Yeah. Oscar, what about you? What's your favorite kind of taco?
Carne asada.
Yeah. Classic, right?
Classic.
Yeah. Ernesto, favorite kind of taco?
Same.
Mm. Yeah.
What about yours?
What about Eileen first? What's Eileen's favorite kind of taco?
I don't eat meat.
Oh. Okay. My favorite kind of taco? I don't know. Probably
yes. There's no bad tacos.
Yep. With lots of cuz then I like dip the whole taco in the guacamole and then you eat it. I don't mess around, Yolanda. I know how to eat.
Mess around with food.
No, can't. Okay. Good. So Evelyn, this is a number we don't know what it is. Like when I point, I mean this entire thing, right? And so if we had something like this on our quiz on Thursday, and the instruction said simplify, what it's asking us to do is to write this number in a way that a little easier. See, Ernesto, the thing is, we don't know what x is at all. X is just some random number. That's all we know about it. Right? It's unknown. It's unknown. We don't know. All right. So, but what we do know is that, do you remember the, I'm trying to figure out where I can write this so it'll like kind of make some sense. So I'm going to put some dots over here. Here's just some ideas. What we do know is that, well, Jackie, do you remember what the radicand is? Like, do you remember what a radicand is? You're right, Jackie. It's the number inside the square root. Yeah. The radicand is a cubed number. See how I see that? Ernesto? You ever noticed how, like, somebody that's good at math, you ask them a question like this, and they're like, oh, it's just this. Yeah? Seen that? It's frustrating. Makes you feel dumb, right? Somebody that can, like, simplify this super fast. These are all the things that they're recognizing, like, immediately. Because they don't, like, somebody that's really good at math, they don't just look at it and say, oh, what do I do? They look at it and see what it's, see what they have. Because what you have kind of determines what you're going to do. So when I see this, I see it's x, which means it's unknown. But it's cubed, which means a number times itself three times, right? So that would be x times x times x. Yeah, yeah? Okay, so we're building the ideas behind this so that hopefully, like, you'll be able to do this kind of question, like, super fast. If not, maybe you can find a radioactive mass spider and get bitten before Thursday's quiz, and then you'll just be rock solid. That's what happened to me. The radioactive mass spider. Yeah. Okay. So, here's the other thing. The square root of x cubed asks, what times itself? Is x cubed. That's what it's asking, the whole thing. It's tricky because I don't know what times itself is x cubed, but I do know that that's x times x times x. Did you kill your brother?
No.
No? Is he here? Where is he?
I don't know.
He's ditching? Yeah. You left him at home, huh?
Yeah.
On the you left him on the side of the road? You look like a nice person. I can't believe you did that to poor Hakobo. All right. Okay. So anyway, back on track. This is asking what times itself is x cubed. So what number times itself is x cubed? I have no idea the answer. That's a very confusing question. But here's how we figure it out. You factor the radicand, the number on the inside, right? To find a perfect square. Because that's what they're looking for. This thing, whole thing is asking for a perfect square. And you might not see, you might see like what that's going to be right away, but maybe not. Jackie, do you see what's going to happen yet?
Mm-hmm.
Oh my good Lord, Jackie. Jackie, check this out. I'm going to write something down. I want you to tell me if this is really equal. Is that true? Is x squared times x equal to x cubed? Right, Marlene?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay, so here's what we're going to do. Because this is true, this would also be true. What we're trying to do is we're trying to see if there's any part of x cubed that we could that's a perfect square. Is there any part of x cubed that's a perfect square? And there is, right here. This is x. That's just plain old-fashioned x, and the square root of x stays there. What's x again, Marlene? I don't know either. The only thing I know is that it's a number. Do you know what number it is, Eileen?
One?
Could be.
Any number?
It could be any number. We don't know what number it is. Yeah. Maybe Daniela knows what number it is, but I don't know what number. Do you know what number it is? I don't know what number it is either. Oscar knows. No? Some random number. We don't have a clue. Jackie, you know what number it is, Jackie?
Five.
You think it's five? Could be five. Could be one. Could be 42. It could be Yolanda's favorite number, 27,292. That's your favorite number, right, Yolanda?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, this one right here? 27,292. Those of you who have seven probably feel silly right now. Seven is your favorite number because that number is way cooler than seven. Look, every other one's a two. And two times two times two is eight. Eight is two cubed. Would you agree? Two times two times two is eight. So check this out. I'm going to relate this to this. Watch out. Well, you thought I was probably just being silly and random, huh? Dang, Marlene, there's a method to my madness, Marlene. You see that? You see that? Look at that. You thought that was just silly. You thought that was silly. That is my favorite number, though. You know why? Jackie, you know why that's my favorite number? Because it's badass. Look at it. That's pretty cool. It's funny looking? Well, yeah. Okay. This is asking what number times itself is 8. Ernesto, do you know what number times itself is 8?
2 squared times 2.
Dang, what a nerd. Ernesto, nerds get jobs. It's good. That's why we're here, right? You're right. He said 4 times 2. He really said 2 squared. The 4, right? Same thing? Here's what he really said. He said 2 squared times 2 because he was, dang, Ernesto was making sense of, he was, oh, look at, you did that, huh? Dang. Evelyn, you see how he did that?
Yeah.
I think he may have been bitten by a mass spider. Where did you find that mass spider, Ernesto? No? You don't know? Okay. But you're right. Square root of 4 is 2. Square root of 2 is just the square root of 2. That's it. This equals the square root of 8. And this right here, this is when it asks you to simplify it. That is simplified. Hi, Gabby.
Hi.
How's Ross?
Full.
It's cool?
Full.
Oh, full. Oh, I know. God. That place. Man. Yeah, you think Safeway in Green Valley is bad, Oscar. You should try Ross in Nogales. Can you imagine? Yeah, that'd be crazy. Okay. What's your question, Oscar?
How did you come up with 8?
I just made it up. I made it up because 8 is a cube, like x cubed was a cube. So I just made up another one. So I'm going to make up another one. I want you guys to try this one. 27, because here's the clue. 3 times 3 times 3 is 27. Go ahead, Jackie. Quit looking at your phone. Put your phone away. Your phone's going to make you... You know what? If you don't stop looking at your phone, you're going to work at, like, Oxxo.
At Oxxo?
Uh-huh. You're going to be mopping the floors with that really stinky soap.
Your stories.
Why is that racist?
Because why would Mexico Oxxo mop smell bad?
I didn't say they smell bad. They're just pungent. They're like super pungent.
They're
like really stinky. I mean, they smell strong, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, why is that racist?
I don't know.
Against what?
Because it had to be in Mexico.
Oh, I thought that was a country, not a race.
Well, it was Mexican.
That's a nationality, not a race.
Same.
No.
Yes.
Oh, no.
Oh, yeah.
No, there's a big difference between nationality and race, because there's only one race.
Which is?
The human race. If you think Mexicans are race, that's racist. Oh, Jackie. You gotta get up earlier, Jackie. Come on, try this one. Try this one right here. Here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna try the square root of 27. 27. Just zip it up, put it away. Just zip it up, put it away. Just do yourself a favor. Just zip it up. Just zip it up. Put it away. That's not zip up, put it away. You're gonna look at it again. Okay. How many of you guys think Jackie's gonna look at the phone in less than 5 minutes? Oh, yeah, see? Okay, let's see. 1342. Okay, by 18, I'll even give you the 19 minutes. I bet you can't make it. Okay. Do you have this one, Daniela? It's supposed to rain tomorrow and Thursday.
It's a little windy, baby.
I'm looking forward to the rain. Yeah. Eileen, do you have this?
Oh.
Really? You think that's going to help? I'll write the answer down for you. It won't help you. If you think copying down the answer is going to make you learn, then you're wasting your time. Yeah, it was right here. See? Did you get it, Yolanda?
Yes.
Yeah. Daniela, you got it? Mm-mm. Here's why this is true. You ready? Check it out. 27 is 9 times 3, would you, right? And this says what times itself is 9. So that number right there is just plain old number 3. And this is what's left over. So on your quiz on Thursday, Evelyn, this is what's going to happen, okay? You're going to have a square root of some number, right? That number right there, it's going to be some other number, some prime number, times a perfect square. And the perfect squares, remember, those are the numbers on the list, like the numbers time, like a number times itself equals this. Like, for example, like if I gave you, like, let's say 3 times 25, that's, you're going to have a problem where you have to figure this out. So it'd be something like square root of 75. This is asking you what times itself is 75. What you got to do is you got to figure out what times a perfect square equals 75. And so that's, you know, I just 3/4 in there. So then what you do is you break it apart. Are you comfortable with that, Ernesto? Kinda? So you gotta break this number apart, the 75, and you gotta find the biggest perfect square. Another example would be 48. So what I'm saying is that if you can simplify this, there's a number times a perfect square that equals 48. And your job is to find that number times the perfect square. So you could just do the factors of 48. So that's 1 and 48, no good. 2 and 24, 3 and 16, 4 and 12, and 6 and 8. Oh, you guys can't see all that. How about I read them on the board for you?
Yes.
Does that work?
Yeah.
That'll be $10 per number. So what do you want to leave out? You might want me to put one on there? That's $10.
Just okay. Anything above 100.
Oh.
<Do those. laughs>
Well, you probably won't have anything that large.
Oh,
yeah. Yeah. So look at our list right here. We got to find the biggest perfect square. So 4 is a perfect square, but it's not the biggest one because 16 is a biggest square, and that's bigger. Because the number times itself that's 16 is 4, right? The number times itself that's 16 is 4. 4 times 4 is 16. So what we're going to do is we're going to break this apart. 16 times 3 is 48. And the number times itself that's 16, just like we just said, is 4. That's what you have to do. You have to be able to do that on Thursday. Evelyn, can you handle that? Yeah? You sure, Evelyn?
Yeah.
Okay, that's $10.
Like right now?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And later. Yeah. Okay.
Any questions on the quiz?
I don't remember. It's a one page front and back. You will have plenty of time. Mm-hmm. You'll have plenty of time if you know what you're doing. If you don't know how to do this and you're going to try to figure it out, you're not going to have enough time because,
right.
Yeah, because then you're going to panic and, yeah. Yeah, okay. You know what else you have to be able to do on the quiz? The F word. Mm-hmm, fractions. Like, you have to be able to do something. I'm just going to make up 2 fractions. 2/3, and what's our other fraction you want, Oscar? What's your favorite fraction?
1/5.
So you're going to have to be able to add those. You're going to have to be able to, say, do something like that. You're going to have to be able to do something like this. Oh. Now it looks like your picture in the yearbook. Look at that, Ernesto. Ha! Sorry. Forgive me. Evelyn told me to say that. I've never even said that joke ever. In my whole life, I've never said that. She told me to say it. I thought that was really rude, but she gave me $20. So you also have to be able to multiply and divide. Hmm. Gabby's like, yes, I was hoping for that. Gabby, fractions are your friend.
No.
No? Gabby, I'm glad you guys are in this class. Because where my wife works, she's the she's the boss. Like, she works at a dental office, and she's not the dentist, but she's like the office manager. So she does the hiring, the firing, the scheduling, all the everything, right? And so they hired a new employee, and they're really happy with her. This new employee, they're really happy with her. And she's a dental assistant, so she like prepares all the tools for surgery, and then she like hands the tools that the dentist needs and stuff like that to them, right? And so, but she's new, and they work in Green Valley, so there's a lot of old people, and sometimes they have to do other care besides dental stuff, because sometimes when you have a surgery, your body can go into shock, so they have to be CPR certified and all this other stuff, right? So today they were trying to teach this new employee who's 60 years old. They're trying to teach her how to check somebody's pulse. And you do pulse, if you don't know, pulse is six is by beats per minute. Right? So your pulse would be like 60 beats per minute. That means your heart would pump once every second. Or if you're kind of nervous or like running, it might be 120 beats per minute, and that's two beats every second. Right? Follow me, Evelyn? So when you check somebody's pulse, you don't do it for a whole minute. That'd take forever. Can you imagine somebody having their hand on your wrist for a minute? Unless they are your boyfriend or girlfriend or something like that. That would be kind of awkward. So they usually do it for 15 seconds or for 20 seconds. So if they do it for 15 seconds, then they take the number that they counted and they multiply by 4. Because 4 times 15 is 60, right? So you can count for 15 minutes and multiply by 4, and that gives you pretty close to what it would have been for a minute, right? So they told that to this lady, and she said she didn't know how to multiply by 4. So they decided to make it easier, and they said, well, what if you did it for 30 seconds and you multiplied by 2? Not a clue. She did not know how to multiply by 2. And so then my wife asked her, well, what if you counted 30 in 30 seconds and you multiplied by 2 to get the beats per minute? Not a clue. She's like, I don't know how to multiply by 2. And then she said, well, what's 30 plus 30? And the lady's like, oh, that's 60. She knew how to multiply by 2. She just didn't think she knew how to multiply 2 by 2 because she thought it was math. It's silly, but it's sad because that's what happens. Like, we think something's difficult, and before giving yourself a chance, you're like, oh, I can't do that. That's math. Gabby, I think you do that with fractions. That lady, the new employee, she's not dumb at all. She knows how to multiply by 2 and by 3 and by 4. She knows how to do that. She's a fully functioning adult. But she heard multiply, she thought math and thought, oh, I can't do math. And as soon as you saw that, you were like, oh, I can't do that. Right? So the reason I'm glad you're in this class is because you're going to do well, and then you're going to get a lot of confidence. Okay. Yeah. You should try these. Try all 5. Go ahead. Try all 5. You guys try all 5. Let's see how we do. Jackie, you look so sad now. You don't have your phone. You got nothing but math. You can't avoid it. Very sad. Yeah? Yeah. You know what this bottle right here is filled with? Jackie? Yeah, try it. Student tears. That's how I live forever. That's how I look this young when I'm really going to be 65 this year. Isn't that crazy, Jackie?
Very.
No way. Seriously?
See, you bring math into the mix and forget it.
I know. No, I'm not going to be 65.
Oh, funny.
That's what I tell my high school students. And they believe me because, well, my kids are old. Because we started young. My youngest daughter is 19. My oldest daughter is going to be 25. Yeah. Jackie, when you do well on your quiz, it's going to make you feel good. It's going to give you a lot of confidence. And then when you get a new job and they ask you to multiply something by two, you won't embarrass yourself. Eileen's going to have to put her phone away, though. I don't know why she got her phone. You can't use your phone on your quiz at all tomorrow. I know, that's even worse, though, isn't it? Thursday. That's even worse, though, isn't it, Eileen? Because that means you're avoiding. Eileen, if you don't try these now, you know what's going to happen? The first time you try these will be on the quiz, and you won't get them. I've been doing this a long time, Eileen. Now, if you forgot, right now you could use your notes. That's not a bad idea. That's what studying's for, right? So you can remember. Were you jamming to Beartooth earlier? No? You sure? Okay. Sticking to Britney Spears for now?
For now.
For now? Okay. That's good. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay. Or are you like a One Direction kind of guy? But they broke up and they went two directions. That was a few years ago, I know, but you know, still a good joke. Oh, you can't help yourself, right? No, I understand. I got it. I got you. Evelyn, how are you doing on these?
I finished.
Yeah, you got them right?
No, but I hope so.
You hope so, but you're not confident. So let me ask you this. On the first three, did you get a common denominator?
Yeah.
Okay. Was it 15?
Yeah.
Okay. And the other two, you didn't have to do that, right? This one was the easiest, right?
Yeah.
This one, you had to flip it over. Did you get, for the very last one, this one right here, Evelyn, did you get 10 over 3?
Mm-hmm.
What'd you get? Oh, you want to say?
No.
Okay. I mean, 10 over 3 might be wrong. I was just asking a question. I wasn't saying that was right.
No, I know.
Oh, okay.
I'm going to fix it.
You're going to fix it? Okay. Yolanda, how are you feeling on these?
Okay.
These okay, square roots not so much.
Actually, square roots is okay.
You guys are getting along now?
Yes.
So it's exponents.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, we're going to talk about those today.
Okay.
That's what I want to spend most of our time on today is exponents. But I thought a little review would be a good idea.
Mm-hmm.
Especially this part, Yolanda. I wanted to make sure that you guys understood when you're simplifying a square root, you're looking for a perfect square times another number. And they're just going to always work out that way. Okay, Jackie. Jackie accusing me of being a racist.
I caught
her. That's racist. Jackie, what does racist mean?
When you don't like someone or you judge them based on
But isn't that prejudice, not racism?
Well, on the look and how they were raised, or because they're different from you.
But that's not race, though. That could be anything. You could be a male and hate all females. That's called a misogynist. But that's not racist.
Then what would be the definition of racism?
That's what I'm asking you. You called me a racist, so I wanted to know what you're saying.
Well, I called everyone that.
Well, I know. I just wanted to know what you thought a racist was. Here's what a racist is. A racist is somebody that doesn't like somebody of a certain ethnicity, but they hate everybody of that ethnicity. Like, I hate all white people, for example. No, I was giving you an example.
Oh.
Yeah. That would be racist. But judging somebody based on how they look is called prejudice. Yeah, you're like, oh, that person, who all people like this, that look like this, this is how they are. But that's actually not such a bad thing. We all need that. Because otherwise, you would get really confused. You would treat old people like toddlers. It's when you do it in a negative way that it becomes discrimination. Ooh, I don't like people with eyes. They're always looking around all shifty. I don't like them, Marlene. Gotta watch out for those people with eyes. Hate people with eyes. And then you treat them bad because they have eyes. That's discrimination. You see? That's how it works, Jackie. Jackie, you're gonna learn all kinds of stuff. See, I'm teaching you math and how to insult people. Okay, Jackie. This first one. I think your denominator is going to be 15. So I think it's going to be like this. And I think your answer is going to be 10 and 3. I could be wrong. I did it in my head, which means there's a good chance I messed up. Did you guys get 13 over 15? No? Did you? Because you did this right here, right? You multiplied this one by 5 over 5. And this one by 3 over 3. And so you get 10 over 15 plus 3 over 15. And you get that. Yes, Daniela? Daniela got that. Yolanda, did you get that? Mm-hmm. Evelyn, did you get that? You look frustrated. I'm guessing not.
No.
See, that right there, you see what I just did? You see how I judged her, Jackie?
Yeah.
Do you see that? I judged her based on how she looked. But was that bad?
On how she looked?
Yeah.
No, you judged her on her facial expression.
That's how she looks? She looked frustrated, so I assumed she was wrong. Is that bad?
No.
See, it's not always bad. It's what we use to get by. It's called reading body language. But I know what you're talking about. It's different.
Yeah.
Okay. Evelyn, what happened?
I didn't know I had to, like, multiply stuff also. I was just, like, adding across.
Yeah, you got to get the denominator first.
I do. It's on my own.
Okay. All right. Ernesto, did you get that one right or wrong?
I don't know.
Did it wrong? What did you do wrong?
Okay.
You didn't multiply the top?
Yeah, like 5 times 2.
So my best advice for you guys that missed it is to write down what you did wrong in words. Don't just write down the right thing. That's not going to help you. Because when you study, if you just see the right thing, you're not going to be making yourself aware of what you messed up. And then you're going to do it again. And you don't want to do it again. Yes, sir.
So it's a like 5 times 2 is 10, mm-hmm. 15, and then 3. Okay.
Mhm. And then you add the. And the denominator stays the same. Right. Okay. This one's almost the same, except here it's going to be like the denominator is still 15, and you're still going to get the same way, but this is going to be a negative 10, and this is going to be a 3. That makes negative 7. Unless I messed up. Daniela, did I mess it up? Not unless you messed it up the same way. Did you get it, Oscar? Did you get the first one, too?
Yeah.
So you're like butter. You're on a roll.
So far.
What's that?
So far, yes.
So far, so good, right? I think you have the attitude, though, so far, so good, so what? Right? I'm going to wait for it to fall apart. Oh, yeah. Got to find confidence in success. All right. Jackie, did you get that one right? What'd you did wrong?
I didn't do
that one. That's even worse. Okay. Next one. They're both negative, so it's actually the same as this one, except it's going to be a negative answer. Negative 13 over 15. How many of you guys got all 3 out of 3 right, the first 3? Dang, Marley. Oh, dang. Yeah. You missed
negative
the last one?
13 over 15?
Yes, ma'am. Because it's minus a negative, like this.
Mm-hmm.
So they're the same. So when you're adding or subtracting, right? If the signs are the same, you just add the numbers and you keep the sign. So let's talk about the denominator first. So you know that you're going to multiply this one by 5 over 5. I'm going to put parentheses so it doesn't look like subtraction. And you're going to multiply this one by 3 over 3, right? That's negative 10 over 15. Minus 3 over 15. And so, look, it's kind of like this. Let's say this is 0, and let's say that's negative 10. if I'm starting at negative 10 and I'm going to subtract 3, that means I'm going to count 3 more this way. 1, 2, 3, and I end up right there, which is negative 13.
Oh, you know what I did was I multiplied the numerators and then the denominators. So I had 2 over 15.
Oh.
And
1 over 15. So you did what Ernesto did on the first one. You multiplied the bottom, but you did not multiply the top.
Uh-huh.
That happens. Okay. Gabby, how are you doing? Did you get them right? No? Do you know what mistakes you made? Just like I told her. If you don't do them now, the first time you try them is on the quiz, and that's not going to work out.
This is, I don't have my other number.
But you still can try.
I said that's where I have my notes.
Oh, I know, I understand, but you can still try them and make mistakes today. Yeah. And this one? 2 over 15. You got that one right?
Yeah.
When it's multiplication, you just got to think Nike.
Just do it.
Just do it. Just do it. Multiply the top, multiply the bottom. D-O-N-E, finish.
Yeah.
And Jackie, it's a good thing I haven't given up on you, Jackie. Jackie, this one, you have to multiply by the reciprocal, which means you turn the second one over, and then you multiply. So that's going to be 10 over 3. You know what I don't have on here, Ernesto, that we need to make sure we're good at, too? R-E-D-U-C-I-N-G-ing. Uh-huh. Reducing. Like, for example, what if I gave you a number? What if you did some math, right? And your final answer was 2 over 4. If you left your answer like that, you're not going to get full credit. Which might be sad, because you might have had to do a whole bunch of work to get that answer. So you may have this big, giant, ugly problem, and it may have taken you 15 minutes to get this as your answer. And that might be right, but it's not done, so you wouldn't lose a point, and that would be sad. Do you know how to reduce that, Ernesto?
It would be 2 over 2, which would be 1
half. 2 out of 4? That's half of 4, right? 2 is half of 4? 2 goes into 2 one time, 2 goes into 2... 2 goes into 4 2 times. Yeah. 2 is the common multiple between, or the common factor. 2 is the common factor between 2 and 4, so that's what you divide. Yeah. Any questions on fractions before we move on? Evelyn? Do you have a pregunta?
Fractions are easy, but when we get to these, when you have 3 different fractions.
Yeah, I didn't mention that. We didn't have that something like that.
Good. Can I see which one you're talking about?
Yeah.
I'm going to talk to
you.
Number 7. Ooh, that's ugly.
Yeah.
Ooh, this one's ugly. Okay, so first of all, you won't have any numbers that big.
Okay.
They'll be smaller. Cochise College actually likes giving tests with ugly numbers like that without a calculator. And I don't know. I think people miss them for reasons that have nothing to do with whether or not they can do the math. They get frustrated because the numbers are too big and they feel defeated. Or they make just a simple mistake, like an adding mistake, but their process is right. So this is addition and subtraction, right? And in order to subtract or add fractions, you have to have common denominators, right? Now you got two ways you could do this. You could put these two together first and then subtract that. Like, for example, you could do, like, if you're going to do this calculation right here, 5 plus 3 minus 2, you could do 8 minus 2 is 6, Or you could also do this if you wanted. You could subtract those two together first and get 5 plus 1, which is 6. You could do it either way. So what I'm saying, Evelyn, is you could put these two together first. Okay. Or if you wanted, you could put these two together first. Yeah. And then whatever's... So if you put these two together first, when you got that answer, then you would add this to it. Or if you put these two together first, then you could do these. You could even do it like this. We could even put the outside ones together first. That makes 5 minus 2 is 3, plus 3 is 6. You could do it that way if you wanted even. So we could add these two on the outside first and then put that one with it. It's your choice. I think I would like to put these two together first, because that seems easiest to me. But this is a hard problem because the numbers are big. 33, 10, and 12, those are large numbers. Well, we're going to have a large denominator. Yeah. So I would like to put these two together because 10 and 12, those are pretty easy. The smallest thing they both go into, I think, is 60. Yeah. So I'm going to change this one right here. I'm going to do this as scratch work. Here's what we're going to do. It is Valentine's Day tomorrow. So... 4 and 7 tenths, that is 47 over 10, minus 13 over 12. So I'm going to do that as scratch work up there. So that's why I put the heart around it, because I'm going to do it over here. I don't want to do it all underneath. So, dang, common denominator of 60. That means I have to multiply this by 5 over 5. And I have to multiply this by... Sace over your face. I mean, sace. Yeah? Evelyn, we're good?
Yeah.
Okay, Evelyn. 6 times 47. Ugh. Danielle, you know your 47 multiplication table? Me either. 47 and 6. We gotta do it old school, like the way you learned it in your old school. I think 6 times 7 is 42. 24, 28. That's it. 282.
I used to write it different.
What?
Like four plus,
oh, why did I get that?
Because on the other one, plus 4,
7, 10. Yeah, so here's what I did. No, I changed 4 and 7 over 10 into an improper fraction. Ah, thank you. I didn't. You're right. Here's what I did. I multiplied these, and then I add it to that, and that's how you get 47 over 10. Uh-huh. Yeah, I changed it to an improper fraction. Thank you for mentioning that, because I didn't say it. I just did it. And the reason I did it is because I think math with these is easier than with the... These are called mixed numbers. I think it's easier with an improper fraction. Dang. All right. So this one's going to be 282 minus 65 over... 60. Hmm. 282 minus 65. Anybody know what that is? You got that, Oscar? 282 minus 65?
217.
217? Okay. I believe you. So that is that. Yes, no, maybe so? So this is this. I did it all as scratch work up here, but that's what it is. If I gave you a problem like this on a quiz, if you did have one like this on a quiz or a test, you would have a lot of time to do it, because you have to take your time. And you have to use a lot of space. Yeah, you just have to be careful. Okay. Man, you sad that your brother's not here now? No? You want him to fail? Siblings. Is that your brother? No. How do you know? You seem so confident it's not your brother. Makes me wonder if you did something bad to him. That's interesting. Okay, now these two. Okay, I don't even want to do this problem. When I see this, just like you, I'm like, 33 and 60? That's stupid. Those are too big. I don't want to do 33 and 60, but we can do this. Look, 33 and 60. 33 and 60. We have to find the smallest thing they both go into. And I know that we don't have to multiply them together because 3 goes into both. Yeah. Dang. So this is 3 times 11, and this is 3 times 20. So 3 times 20 times 11 is our answer. Ugh. That's an ugly number. I won't give you a problem with numbers that big on a test. 3 times 20, so 60 times 11. 660. I am pretty sure that I'm going to use a calculator. Should we use a calculator? So, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to make sure that 660 is divisible by 33. I want to see if there's 33 go into it. Oh, it's amazing. Times 20 over 20. Isn't that incredible? 20 over 20. So that's 700. Do you know how I got 700 really quick, Ernesto, out of these two right here? Here's what I did. I know that 35 times 2 is 70. And 20 is 10 times 2. So here's what I saw. When I see these two right here, right? Here's what I see. I see 2 times 35 times 10. That's what I see. Because 20 is 2 times 10, but I did it this way because that's 70 times 10 is 700. Yeah. You want to know how I learned how to do 2 times like 35, Oscar? As a cashier. When you used to count change. Like now, do you do cashier stuff at Safeway now? But you know how the change comes out at the machine? You don't have to count it anymore? Yeah. It didn't used to be that way, and then you would be able to learn. You had to learn stuff like that. But you didn't learn it in school. You learned it when you worked. Okay. And then this one's going to be times 11, 217 times 11. Let's see. I'm going to make sure. Oh, yeah. So I just have to subtract 700 in that number. 1687 over 660. I will not give you a problem with numbers that big. What if I give you a problem with numbers like small numbers? But like this. Could you do it, you think? You want to try, Jackie? Mm-hmm. Okay, Jackie. Let's try this. Let's do one. Let's try one. Marlene, what's your favorite fraction? Well, that's fair. You can still have a favorite one of the ones you don't like. Like, I don't like generic ice cream. You know what I mean? Like the store brand ice cream, I don't like it. But there's one that is my favorite of those I don't like. It's Tin Roof. It's pretty good. I also don't like Burger King. But my favorite thing at Burger King would be a Whopper. Yeah. So what's your favorite fraction? 2/3? Good. -2/3. Okay. Plus, I think that this is Yolanda's favorite. 5/2.
-2/2 or the whole thing?
Yep. And -1. Oh, do not let me trick you. I'm not trying to trick you, but don't trick yourself. 3 + 2 = 5, but you don't get common denominators by adding. It's by a cow's favorite kind of math. Right, Gabby? Gotta multiply. We love cow jokes. So you guys try this one. Come on, Danielle. You gotta quit texting me. I'm old and married. It's creepy. Come on, Evelyn, you can get this. I have faith in you. I think I have more faith in you, in some of you guys with this fraction stuff than you guys have in you. You know why I have faith in you guys? It's not because I'm on all puppy dogs and lollipops kind of person. Oh, everybody's so wonderful. It's not that. I'm not that kind of person. But I have faith in you guys because I've been doing this a long time and I know what people, all people, can do. And I know that all people can do this. It's just a matter of if you're going to make yourself learn it or not. Right, Marlene? Marlene, Marlene, Marlene. It's a good thing I like you, Marlene. I know what we need right now. Hold on, I don't know if this is going to work, but I'm going to try it while you guys work on this.
It's not working.
No?
Nope.
Hmm. You get stuck?
Yes.
Hmm. One second. I don't know if this is going to work or not. We're going to find out. Oh, yeah, it's going to work. This is going to be awesome. Hold on. I got to wait for the commercial to go away. Okay, you need some motivation. There we go.
Too late. I already died.
Oh, no, we got this. You know what happens? Rocky looks like he's going to lose and comes back. This is what's
going to
happen.
No, I get it. All right? All right, so I tried to wait.
Thank you.
You know that movie, Daniela? Oh my gosh. She doesn't know the movie.
Do you have electricity in your cave? Yeah? You've never seen Rocky? You've never seen Rocky? Oh my gosh, are you serious? Oh, that's sad. Like this movie right here? You never seen that movie?
We can't see it.
Oh, I hate my life. You've never seen that? Oh my goodness. Have you seen it, Oscar? You know the song?
Yeah.
Oh my goodness. Oh, wow. Okay. We have things to fix. We're gonna have to, you guys are all going to have to watch the Rocky movie because you don't understand why it's appropriate. Because like in every Rocky movie, there's like 27 of them or something. It's a lot. I don't know. Actually, I think there's seven. Maybe eight. So, and then the new one, the Apollo Creed one, and the son. So there's like, there's a lot. In every single one, the good guy, you're sure he's going to lose. Because everything's going wrong. And then he's victorious in the end. It's a comeback story. Yep. You guys are all in that situation right now. You're in Math 81. You can't be in a lower math class.
Oh, great.
You're down. You're down. It's time to be victorious. People don't write stories about people that just win every time. That's no fun. The stories that are interesting are the people that look like they're going to lose. Yeah. All right. Marlene, you ever see Braveheart? The movie Braveheart?
No.
Oh. Okay. Wow. Marlene, it doesn't matter which ones we put together first. We could even do them all at the same time. But we're going to let Ernesto pick which two we do, which ones we're going to put together first. So you put these two together first?
Yeah.
Like these two right here? Okay, that's what Evelyn did too. So this one stays the same. Right? Alright, and then, let's see. This is a little easier, so I think I feel comfortable like squeezing all the numbers in right here and just making this work. So that's a plus 25 over 10. And this is a minus 2 over 10. Is that good? Okay, and that makes 23, right? So negative 2 over 3 plus 23 over 10. Now, Yolanda, you did it a different way, but I think if you did it right, we're going to get the same answer.
Well, we went ahead and tried the other two, and so far, so good.
Okay. So 30, right?
Yes.
30. We got to get a common denominator of 30. And that's what you had earlier when you did the other way, and you had 2 and 15. Right? 30 would be the common denominator.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, Jackie, so we need 30. So we have to multiply this by 3 over 3 and this one by 10 over 10. That's negative 20 over 30 plus 69 over 30. And that gives us 49 over 30. Did you get it right? Don't look so excited. Did you get it right, Ernesto? Did you get it, Yolanda?
Mm-hmm.
Hmm.
Nope.
Did you have the...
I got it as you were doing it.
Right? Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
All right. Oscar, did you get it right?
Yes.
Yes. Okay, Oscar. Okay, onward and upward. We have one thing we have to learn today. We spent all the time reviewing, which is okay, because we have one thing to learn. But let's back up. Let's review what we learned a week ago. A week ago, we learned a couple of things. And these were like the shortcuts, right? The patterns. Is that right? And then we had this. And Oscar, the thing you missed, we talked about where all... Oh. We talked about where all of these shortcuts come from and what they mean. Did we do division last time? Did we do...
Yes.
And that's like that? I thought so. I thought we had three. We have two more for today. Yes, sir.
I was going to ask a question.
What's your question?
For example, like if we have
Like that?
Yeah.
Yeah, you said it right. Yeah, I'm going to get you through that today. Oh, yeah, we're going to do fine. You're going to see. Yeah, I'm going to get you through this today. Yeah. Yeah, anything to the power of zero is one. Do you know why?
That's
one. I'll show you. I'll show you as quickly as possible. All right. So, dang, man, I could not have written a better question for you to ask right now. That was the best question. That was the timing. Dang, this guy, seriously, dang, I'm impressed. He said, "Is this true?" And that's actually the next thing we're going to learn. And yeah, that's true. X could be any number, right? It's just a number. We don't know what it is. Anything to the power of 0 equals 1. So that's a fact, even if you don't know why. So that means if you had some big ugly problem like, oh, I don't know, log base 2 of 7 to the power of X times 4X to the third times X to the negative fifth divided by 27,292 to the 14th power times X, all to the power of 0, guess what that equals? 1. Anything to the power of 0 is 1. Except for 0. That's weird. 0 to the power of 0 is nothing. Okay. So, Eileen, here's why this works. Anything to the power of 0 is 1. So, like, for example, let's talk about x to the fifth. What's x to the fifth mean? What's that 5 mean right there? That 5 right there. Oscar, do you know, you weren't here on when we did this. Do you know what that means?
X to the fifth power?
Yeah. Not sure? What it means? Okay. So 5 times x means we would have 5 x's all adding. Okay? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is the same thing except instead of adding, it's repeated multiplication. So the 5 describes how many of these are being multiplied together. Okay? That's what exponents are. They're a way of writing a really big number in an easy way. Like, for example, like if we wanted to do 27 to the 403rd power, we can write that. But a calculator can't write that number. It says 27 to the power of 403. That would be 403 27s, all of them multiplying. You might think that's like a crazy number, right? But that can happen. Like, yeah. Just things multiplying together. Like in finance, it's going to happen all the time. You have big, giant numbers. But we wouldn't write the number out. We would write this instead. So exponents give us a way of writing a really big, ugly number in something that's easy to see. Okay, so x to the fifth is, right? Now, what if I were going to divide x to the fifth? I'm not doing a step. I'm just like messing around with some numbers here. What if I divided x to the fifth by x to the fifth? Check this out, Jackie. This is 5x is all multiplying right here, right? Mm-hmm. So that would be 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Would you agree? Mm-hmm. Okay. Marlene, would you agree that a number divided by itself equals 1? Mm-hmm. So this equals 1. Because x is itself, and this equals 1, and this equals 1, and this equals 1, and this equals 1. 1 times 1 times 1 times 1 times 1 is 1 over 1. 1 over 1 is 1. Duh, right? Something divided by itself is 1. If we used the shortcut here for this problem, we would have x to the power of 5 minus 5, which is 0. And we just saw that this equals 1. It doesn't matter what x is. It doesn't matter what those numbers are. Anything divided by itself is 1. And the way you get the 0 right here, the way you get this 0 is from dividing something by itself, because then you would subtract those exponents. So even if you don't know that, even if you don't understand that, you got to know this rule. You know this rule, you're good. It's the easy one. Yeah. Not like anybody in particular, but it's like so easy it should be a your mama joke. Yeah. Like your mama's easier than that math problem. Right. Right, Jackie?
Yeah.
Uh-huh. That's racist, Jackie.
It's very racist.
Yeah, against mothers. The race of mothers.
The race.
The race of mothers. That's right. Okay. All right, Evelyn. Here's the tricky one, though. You ready? Because this one's easy. I don't think we need to... Yeah, you just... Power 0, it's equal to 1. So, like, the question you asked right here. You know what makes this one tricky right here? Is what does this exponent go to? It goes to the x, for sure. But does this exponent of 0, does it also go to the 2? That's the tricky part. The question about this part right in here. Let's just look at that part. The question is... What has an exponent of 0? That's the question. Is it x or is it negative 2x?
X.
It's just the x. It's just the x. If it was both, it wouldn't be written like this. It would be written like this. That's different. Now everything has an exponent of 2. This whole thing equals 1. This whole thing right here equals negative 2 times 1. You're going to have to write times 1. You know what would be cool, Yolanda, is if the pen I was writing with matched your sweater. Why, isn't that weird? Oh, it doesn't look like it on there, though, does it?
No.
Oh, it does. It is, though. See?
It looks purple.
It's, oh, well, it is. Well, it's very purple on here.
I mean,
blue.
It looks blue on there. It's purple. All right. All right, Gabby. Gabby, here we go. Gabby, this is going to be awesome. You ready? You sure, Gabby? Gabby, I'm excited about this. Here's our last rule. Our last rule is this. This is the confusing one. That says x to the power of negative m. I'm going to tell you where it comes from, and I'm hoping that it will help you remember. It might help you remember. It might not. Evelyn, do you know what negative means? You're right. Opposite. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Good. That's good, Evelyn. Yeah. Yolanda is glad you said it, because she was going to get confused. Negative means opposite. Okay? You got your head around that, right? Negative means opposite. Like, subtraction is the opposite of addition. Okay? Negative means opposite. Evelyn, you're in the hot seat again. Ready? What do exponents mean? You're right. Repeated multiplication.
Yeah.
That's good. That's good. That's good. So, Daniela, negative is opposite. Exponents, repeated multiplication. Yeah? Negative exponents are the opposite of repeated multiplication. They are repeated division. So, we're going to write that out right here. Negative exponents are repeated division. That's true. Negative exponents are repeated division. So the trick is, Yolanda, is how do you write division? Because we're not going to use this symbol to write it. We're not going to use that. Oh, boy. So let me see if I can help us out here. Check it out, Jackie. What's your favorite single-digit number? 5? Good. 5. Ready, Jackie?
Mm-hmm.
Divided by x to the third. How would we divide that? Are you confused? Let me see. Let's make it easier then. How would we do this? How could we... Well, first of all, do you know what that number equals? 10 divided by 2? 5, right? But how do you write it? How do you divide by a number? Tell us, Ernesto. Save us, please. We're going to change your name to Jesus. You multiply by the reciprocal. You're right. You change it to a fraction. You flip it over. This is 10 times 1/2. Do you see how you flip it over? That's how you divide. Division is multiplication by the reciprocal. That means you take the second number, you flip it over. Just like with those fractions from before, right? So what we do to divide is we rewrite division as multiplication by the reciprocal. So this is really going to be 5 times 1 over x cubed. Nope. It's just because we're dividing by this number. So we put a 1 under it, flip it over, and change the symbol to 2 multiplication. Right? Put a 1 under it, flip it over, change the symbol to multiplication. That's how you write division. Like, for example, what we did last week would be, like, or 2 weeks ago, I think, would be something like this. The way we do something like that is you take the second number, first one stays the same, take the second number, flip it over, change the symbol to multiplication, and then you do it. Right? That's how this works. So instead of writing this thing right here, what we write instead is that. Oh, sorry, x to the negative third. That's what we'd write instead. So instead of writing divided by x to the third, what we really write is times x to the negative third. They mean the same thing. This and this are the same. And that's also the same as 1 over x to the third.
Would it be easier if we just put it in
this is the, so if you end up with a negative exponent, you have to rewrite it like that.
You always have to make it a positive?
Mm-hmm. You need to write it as a positive exponent.
Never
it means you flip it. Yeah.
That's only when you're dividing?
That's if it's a negative exponent. Negative exponent's always dividing. Yeah. So here's the last shortcut. This is 1 over x to the power of m. Yeah. How's that seem so far, Yolanda? Crazy, weird?
It's crazy.
Kind of strange, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I'm hoping that this will make more sense. I mean, it makes perfect sense to me because I know it. Mm-hmm. But I bet there's stuff you know how to do. You could explain it to me. It would make perfect sense to you, and I'd be sitting there going, I think all of those words were English. But I have no idea what you're talking about. This will make sense, I hope, eventually. Mm-hmm. When you get it, it's going to make sense. Just like, remember we talked about last week, Evelyn? When you learn something, the words that describe that thing, they don't change. But your brain does. It makes sense of it. This is what happens with negative exponents. It's repeated division. So the way you do it, the way you handle it, like, let's talk about the problem that Ernesto had for us just a second ago, right? Where was it? Yeah, right here. X squared times negative 2x to the 0 to the negative 5th. That one? Mm-hmm. I think we can handle this. It's going to be bad donkey. You know why we say bad donkey? Evelyn, you know why we say bad donkey? Uh-huh. Yeah, donkey in the Bible's ass. It's bad donkey. Okay. Do you guys know what PEMDAS is, right? The order of operations? That's always in play. You're always using it. It's not its own topic. So when we look at this, we have to consider the order of operations. And we have a parenthesis right here. We have to take care of what's inside of here before we can do anything else. We can't multiply. This is multiplying with this. And we can't do this exponent until we take care of the parenthesis first. ¿Claro? Okay. So, we talked about that a minute ago. This is just equal to negative 2 times 1. And you don't need to write times 1. We did that a second ago. And in case you forgot, it's because of this, right? That number is equal to 1. So that's really negative 2 times 1, and that's just really negative 2. Yeah? So this thing right here. Yeah? All we did is evaluate what that is right there. Okay, now you can't multiply first. You have to do the exponent first. How do you write divided by negative 2 to the 5th? Because that's what this says. This says divided by negative 2 to the 5th. Negative exponent is division. How do you write this? Because when you see this, this is what you should recognize. We don't write it this way. We don't write it this way, but this means this. Math is a language, and the way it's written has all the meaning. That little negative exponent means that thing right there. Put a 1 under it, flip it. Yeah? So, that's what we're going to do. Multiply those two together. Done. That's it, Yolanda. So, Ernesto, you're not going to multiply 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 5 times and get 32. Don't do that.
That's what I was
going to
add.
Yeah.
So you just say good like.
Mm-hmm. If you're dealing with exponents, unless it says to write out the whole the entire number, just leave it as an exponent. Like, that's the whole purpose, is you don't have to do the multiplication. You get to be lazy with it. Let's try an easy one. Let's do... You do. Don't avoid. You want letters or numbers? Jackie, what's IDK mean? You don't? That's really weird. Okay, Jackie, we're going to do number. You said numbers? Numbers? Okay, what number? 5?
Yeah.
Okay, they're all going to be 5s. But you're not going to multiply 5 times 5. You're going to use exponents. Okay? So, here's what we're going to do. Ooh! Oh, man. Daniela, that problem is making me sweat. Making me nervous. Making Jackie sad. Look at her. Jackie's like, maybe I will go work at Oakville.
A job's a job.
That's true. Maybe I'll be a little mendrosa selling chicle on the side of the road.
Maybe.
Uh-oh.
Sure.
You think they make enough?
No.
No, I don't think so. I feel bad for them.
Me too.
You know they don't make very much at all.
They don't.
I like taking the white chicle and putting it in my mouth like their teeth. You ever do that, Jackie?
It's been a while since I've gotten that gum.
Oh, yeah.
I usually just give them the money.
I think it's funny that gum's name is gum.
Gum's name is gum?
Mm-hmm. That's the brand. It's chicle.
Oh, yeah.
Which is gum. Right. Okay, focus. Oh, yeah. My fault.
We could talk about gum.
Talk about TMJ, which is, the disorders caused by chewing gum.
Oh.
Yeah, but we'll do this instead, because this is on your quiz. TMJ is not on your quiz. You can handle this. Look, follow the order of operations. Mm-hmm. And then you've got a couple rules. Just use the rules. Find out which ones they are. So you got like... Good idea. Just prepared to make a bunch of mistakes. Watch it be Murphy's Law and then you make no more mistakes.
I know.
Would it be worth the investment of the $1.50 or whatever?
Sure.
Probably. Because then you'd be perfect, just like Evelyn. Right, Evelyn?
Okay. I'm not perfect, but thanks.
Did you get this, Evelyn?
Somewhat.
Because it looked like you stopped.
Yeah.
Like Eileen stopped. And Marlene stopped. That's called avoiding. It's like, oh, I got a math problem to do. Let me change my jacket. Like Mr. Rogers. Well, I have a math problem to do. What's that on the ceiling? Right? Yeah. We find ways of doing, of avoiding things we don't want to do. Like at work, if my boss sends me something to do in an email, I did not get that email. If you want me to do something, you better come tell me personally, and you probably got to tell me twice, because I'm going to forget.
Really?
That's how it is. That's how it is. Yep. In education, if they really want it, they'll ask you a few times. That doesn't matter who the principal is or the superintendent.
Wow.
They come up with all kinds of ideas, but...
No, you're right. Friendly reminder.
Yeah, when you get the reminder, right. It's like, okay, maybe they were really serious. They believed it when they said it, but, you know. The same in the military. They come up with all kinds of ideas. Yeah. Any government thing. They come up with all kinds of stuff for you to do, but they don't really want it unless they ask for it a couple times.
Gotcha.
Words to live by.
I appreciate that.
Yep. And then busy work, turn it in at the very last second.
Say that again?
If you have busy work that you have to do, turn it in at the last second. Otherwise, they look at it and they tell you to fix it. But if it's busy work, you turn it at the last second, they're like, oh, that feels like about right, and they throw it away.
Oh, my God.
See? I got your back, Yolanda.
Oh, thank you.
Yep. Miss Brew's going to be all kind of mad now, huh?
No, I'll stay here, I promise. Gonna say, who have you been hanging out with?
Oh, it'll shine. She knows me. Yeah, I once made a video on how to say no to your boss. Oh,
you
she
did.
Was like, she's like, you've tried those on me. Because there's ways you can work your boss over.
Is
like when they
too?
Ask you to do something, you're like, wow, that's a really good idea. And you like compliment them on the idea, and then you come up with a really good reason why you can't do it. But who do you think might be able to? You throw somebody under the bus. They never suspect it. Yeah.
Where can I watch that video?
It's on my YouTube channel.
It is? Okay.
It's pretty good. How to say no to your boss. Yeah. Without saying no to your boss. No. You gotta work it. All right, Ernesto, did you get this?
Yeah, but
you should probably check with somebody, huh? I think you guys should check with somebody. Yeah. Marlene, you gotta check with somebody. I think you've given up on this, Marlene. You didn't try it, did you?
Yes.
Oh, do you think you got it right? Maybe? Do you think Jackie got it right? You know that Jackie chick right here? Do you know Jackie?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Do you think Jackie got it right?
No, maybe.
Did she try it?
Half.
Jackie, if you tried it, even if you got halfway, then you're gonna eventually get it. It's when you completely avoid it that you'll never get it. Daniela, did you get it? Did you give up? Now you miss your brother, huh? Right? Because sometimes he remembers stuff because he had it last year and you forgot how to do it. Yeah. Okay. Is it weird? Both of them. He and Jackie were in this class last semester. You and Jacobo.
Yeah.
At least he took his final.
I know. I wasn't here for my... Well, that's why I'm here.
That's the only reason, Jackie?
No, because halfway through I didn't do the work.
You gave up, Jackie. Killing me, Smalls. You gotta believe in yourself, Jackie. Otherwise, you're gonna work at Oakso. That's my new thing. You're gonna work at Oakso. You don't want to work there. I don't think you want her. Maybe you do want to work there. I don't know. Do you want to work there, Daniela? No? No. I don't want to work there. I don't think you want to work there. Do you think they get robbed?
They do.
Yeah, see, that's why you don't want to work there. A student told me that today because my joke has always been you don't want to be like working at Circle K at a bad part of town at midnight because you're going to get robbed. And somebody's like, today they were like, oh, no, Oakso would be worse.
Yeah.
So now that's my new thing.
Oakso.
Okay. Daniela, did you put these two together first?
Yeah.
Yeah? Which way did you do that? 1, 2, 3, 4, or 5. Which one did you use to put those together?
One.
One, that's right. Do you guys see that's the first one, right?
Mm-hmm.
To put these two together, which you have to do first because it's in a group, it's in parentheses, that's this. So you're going to add them. It's 2 plus negative 4. 2 plus negative 4. Crap, I hate my life. Math is hard. That's negative 2. Yeah? 2 plus negative 4 is negative 2. Right. Adding is adding. It doesn't matter where it's at. Okay. Now, we have a decision to make. This 5, it's multiplying with that. But this is an exponent. The exponents come first. So we have to put this 3 and 2 together, and that's using this rule, right? So we have to multiply those two together. That would be 5 times 5 to the negative 6. Well, I'll move it so you can see. Oscar, am I going too fast, or are we doing good? Doing good. Okay. Ernesto, we're killing it? We're not done yet. We're not done yet. You know why we're not done yet?
Because you gotta change it into a fraction.
And there's another reason. We have 2 5s. But we can only have, they're the same. 5 is the same as 5, so we gotta get it together with one. There's 1 5 with just a single exponent. So here's what I would do. I'm tempted to use this rule right here, this last rule for that 6. But if we slow down, that 5 has an exponent of 1 right now. And that's this rule right here. That's 5 times 5 to the negative 6. I need to add those exponents. That's 1. That's 1 plus negative 6. That's negative 5. That's 5 to the negative 5. Do you see what I mean, Ernesto?
So you didn't multiply
5
and
5.
You just...
No, because we don't want to multiply the bases because we're using exponents.
Okay. Yeah. So then all you would do is just subtract the exponents?
Yeah, because it's 1 plus negative 6, which makes negative 5. That's this rule right here.
Okay.
Okay, so we're almost done now, though, right? Because we have a negative exponent, and so that's division. So that's going to be 1 over 5 to the power of 5. That's this rule. These are tricky, I know. Practice is super, super important. Exponents are your friend. Exponents never got a friend of theirs a DUI. Nope. Never. Bless you. Exponents never got somebody thrown in jail. Exponents never picked a fight, started a war, killed a kitten, on accident or on purpose. Yep. No, it's true, Marlene. Exponents are nice. Look, we have a quiz on Thursday. There are exponents on it. I would be willing to take like the first 15 minutes of class to help you guys with questions on page number 73. You should be able to do... Man, look at this. You should be able to do everything from, for sure, you should be able to do everything from number 1 through 30. Like, you should be able to do those easy. Well, maybe not easy. But you should be able to learn how to do those so that they become easy. And then, this is just, these are with all numbers. Okay? There's no letters, right? No variables? And then, if you want to practice some with variables, you could look at 31 through 42 on the next page. And that's all X's, which sometimes can seem a little tricky, or sometimes it can seem a little easier. So I would be willing to spend the first part of class answering questions about this. Which doesn't mean, hey, can you do this problem for me and I do it, because that won't help you. It's if you try one and you're like, oh, I'm confused on that, and then I help you out there, that would help. And some of you actually, like the answers for the odds are in the back of the book, and some of you have the teacher's edition, quite a few of you, because I guess that's what they're selling now, which is weird. And the answers are right there on the same page. Okay. Can't miss on Thursday because there's no chances to make up quizzes, so you gotta be here. Gotta be here. All right, boys and girls. Practice those exponents. Gotta practice them. You can get together and practice with them at Starbucks.